Keith Olbermann promises a haberdasher report tonight.
Yeah, we've got a lot of clothing in sports, believe it or not. Does Kings coach Robbie Fedoruk have a lucky sweater? Does he simply just not have enough sweaters? Or did he just like wearing those blue and white uniforms back when he played for the Quebec Nordiques? Whatever the reason, this is how Fedoruk dressed last November in Quebec, and here's how he dressed tonight in Quebec. No fashion risk there. Same sweater. It worked in November. Kings won 3-1. It works tonight. Steve Kasper intercepts a Nordique pass out on the break to beat Quebec goalie Ron Tugnutt. Got to tighten that Tugnutt. One zip. Davy Crockett in semi-retirement, running a 7-11 outside Quebec City. Nordiques unload 24 shots on Kelly Rudy, and he stops them all. The first King shutout in over a year. Last year it came when Bernie Nichols scored just 32 goals last year. Tonight, numbers 62 and 63 for Bernie. Kings win 4-zip, own second place by themselves again. And in the stands, is that a Kings banner down your shirt, or are you just glad to see me? 4-zip the final. Calgary wins 2. The Devils' loss means the Rangers clinch a playoff spot. Whalers 8-2. Washington moves into first place, and the Patrick also clinches a playoff spot. Canucks tie the Red Wings. Toronto beats the Minnesotas. Blues over the Blackhawks, and Mario Lemieux get both of Pittsburgh's goals in their victory. 2 8-2 games tonight. Unable to get a multi-year contract out of the Rams, veteran defensive end Gary Jeter skipped town today and signed a 2-year deal with the New England Patriots, $850,000 total. And we told you last night that the Raiders had signed linebacker Otis Wilson away from the Bears. Today, Wilson himself agreed with us, but the Raiders still say no deal has been made. Don't tell Otis that. He's picking out surfboards.
I'm just elated about the whole situation. I'm excited and looking forward to it. California, here I come.
Not so fast, Kemosabe. Not so fast for the Lakers either, who did not pick up ground in the race for the league's best record tonight at the Hoosier Dome. Hoosier Dome, watch under the basket. James Edwards of the Pistons, ex-Bruin Stuart Gray of Indiana, start the pushy-shovey routine, and then an old-style basketball fight. No punches, just a lot of hold me back, hold me back. After which the refs expel both Edwards and Stuart Gray. Yeah, that's a fair exchange. Pistons are saved tonight only by 15 points in the fourth quarter from Isaiah. Two of them on a shot out of the pages of miniature golf, off the top of the backboard, then straight down. Which is how Indiana coach Dick Versace was wearing his suspenders. Dick, that's not how they work. He got a technical, presumably for not wearing his suspenders properly. 129-117, the final. Detroit. Knicks win. 31 from Ewing, 26 from Johnny Newman. Chambers has 38, and the Phoenix win. Denver over Charlotte. Kings get 29 from Ainge, and the Blazers get 29 from Drexler. From spring training, Fernando Valenzuela and Ramon Martinez both pitch limply as the Dodgers lose to the Reds 10-9, despite 5 Dodger runs in the ninth. That was not a reference to Jim. Kirk Gibson insists he will play opening day despite the knee problem. The big news in Arizona, not the Angels losing in the ninth to Seattle 6-5, but word that Jim Abbott has made the first cut and will still be with them when they shift to Palm Springs Friday. Finally, the Boston promo stop for the Leonard Hearns fight. He's got a gun! Look out, he's got a gun! And so does Hearns. They were doing this Revolutionary War stuff in Fennel Hall. Boston Revolution, get it? Even had Paul Revere.
This newly crowned king, coronated in the palace of Caesar, shall heretofore render unto Caesar that which is called the gate, and unto Lord Aram that which is called the tape.
And that suit's got to be rendered back to the rental shop by 5:30.
You know what Paul Revere said.
Kicks just keep getting harder to find.
I knew you knew it. That's great. Steve Rambo joins us again now for a quick look at tomorrow morning's weather with an eye toward traffic. Steve.
All right. Tomorrow's drive should be pretty.